Hello children, welcome to the next session, session number 2. So it's a combined class for 5th, 6th, 7th classes. So all of you expecting the mathematics to start, but for your sake only I'm going for the basics. So yesterday we went for additions in the session number 1, and today also I'll continue the same additions but with a somewhat word problems. So before going to this, I'd like to clarify one thing is that all the students are, some students are very interested and they are doing the homework, and some students are not doing the homework. You have to do the homework. So what is the homework is, at the last I'll give some work assignment. Don't simply send the questions. Some students send the questions. Of course you don't know how to do. Right now we are in the starting stage only. So don't send the questions. For that, write the answers and send to the concerned sir. Professor sir is there, his mobile number is already given to you. So in this second session, same additions, we'll go for some word problems, right? So word problem, all these questions I'll frame my own. After this, with the same questions, you have to follow or you have to change the numbers and you have to do the answers, right? So just I'll make my own. The population of Hyderabad city if the number of males 6,52,789, it's an approximate one, I'm not going for the regular census. It's a simple numbers what we are going for as for this particular sum, and number of females is 6,26,423 is question mark. So the title is basics in mathematics. So basics, already we have discussed four things: addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. For each one I'll take two sessions. So yesterday I started the addition session, we have done some problems. Today also we'll continue for that. Now the question is, there is Hyderabad. Hyderabad city is there. The population of Hyderabad city, if the number of males is 6,52,789 and the number of females is 6,26,423. Now what we have to do is, we have to find. So males means Magavalu, females means Aravalu. Okay. So answer is, so total population or total population is equal to, what we are going to do is 6,52,789 plus 6,26,423. Here I am not counted the number of children, everything, because it's not, it's a rough sum, or it's a normal sum for our calculation purpose. Okay, now we are going doing the both units, tens, hundreds, thousand, ten thousand, lakhs. Units, tens, hundreds, thousand, ten thousand, lakhs. So better to write units, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands and lakhs. So after this you make it right, then draw the lines right from the starting. 6,52,789 789 plus 6,26,423. Right? Now plus 9 plus 3 is 12. So 2 should be written here and 1 should be carried out. And 2 plus 8, 10. 10 plus 1, 11. So 11 means 1 here and 1 here. You can calculate here or you can calculate from this side, your wish. So 4 plus 7, 11. 11 plus 1, 12. So it is 12, it is 1. And it is 1 is there. So 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 6, 3 plus 6, 9. And there is no carrying out, no need to carry it. So 5 plus 2, 7. And 6 plus 6 is 12. So therefore, units, tens, hundreds, thousand, ten thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs. So therefore, what is the answer? It is 12,79,212. So like this, you have to add. So it's a combination of some carrying and without carrying. Look at this, 7 plus 4, 11, it's a carrying. Now 5 plus 2, 7, in this case, there's no chance of carrying, okay? Next, I'll go for the one more question, the same method. Now, what we had, the point is how to add the given numbers. So if it is a bigger number, better to take in the boxes. So what happens if you don't take the box? So is it mandatory to take the boxes? Is it mandatory? It's not a mandatory, but to avoid confusion. For example, in the meanwhile question, you will get 1112 plus 614. You will get like this. So maximum of the students may write like this and they will add it 2537. Is it right? It is wrong. May write. Some students will write perfectly, but some students may write in this way. So to avoid that, better to have a boxes, right? Next, I'll go for one more question. Question number 2 in this session. So any one of the name, so I'll take Raju. Okay, Raju had 3,69,432 rupees in SBI account and 9,43,215 in HDFC account. So how much money does he had in total? It's a rough numbers. I don't know who is Raju. Sir, tell me Raju, I'll ask some amount from him. Don't say like that. Just I am taking two examples. Here the criteria is just to add the numbers, right? So Raju has two accounts. One is in State Bank of India, SBI, and second thing is HDFC. So what is the total amount he had? So what is the answer? What we have to do is we have to add. So therefore, total amount in Raju accounts is, how to write, 3,69,432 plus 9,43,215. So obviously what we have to do, units, tens, hundreds, thousand and thousand lakhs. Units, tens, hundreds, thousand and thousand lakhs. So same, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands and lakhs. Then I can write first 3,69,432 plus 9,43,215. So what is the next answer? It's very simple, addition. So 2 plus 5, 7. No need to carry out. 3 plus 1, 4, next 4 plus 2, 6, and 9 plus 3, it is 12, so 2 here and 1 here, and 1 plus 6, 7, 7 plus 4, 11, 1 here again, 1 here, then next 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 9, it is 13. So therefore, what is the answer? We can write also, give the statement. Units, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs. So Raju has 13,12,647 in his bank account. Okay. So here the criteria, what you have to learn is that we have to add these numbers. We have to add in a particular manner. We have to add one place of one first number with one space only. So what happens, I'll add like this, I can add these two, means it is wrong. So when you are learning the basics, you have to follow these type of steps. And my suggestion is, as you are in 5th, 6th and 7th class, you can't expect these type of questions. All these questions will be in the 3rd, 4th standards. But my intention is to say is that these type of sums may be come according when you are doing the different sums. There is a chance of getting additions. At that time, you must be very perfect. Okay. So, this is the second question. And third question, I'll go for a regular question. One of the points from the yesterday's one. So, yesterday one question is given. 4 more than 4 digit number and 6 more less than 5 digit number. So I didn't mention whether it is largest 4 digit or smallest 4 digit. The students, they have to think and they have to write their by own. They may take any one of the answers, right? Now one more question, I'll go for this one. So I'll go for this type is number of voters I'll go, right? So our constituency is Pipilapur constituency. Say the number of male voters. The number of male voters in Pipilapur constituency. Pipilapur constituency is 12,45,857 and female voters is 12,32,659. So total number of voters is equals to question mark. Total number of voters. Total number of voters is question mark. That means how many are there? Simple one. So the answer, total number of voters. Total number of voters is equal to what I should do? I have to add 12,45,887 plus 12,32,659. I had to add these two. So this time we had to add more. So ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, lakhs, and 10 lakhs. After framing this, take this one. So this 12,45,887 plus 12,32,659. So what is the next one? So 7 plus 9, it is 16. One should be carried out here. So 1 plus 8, 9. 9 plus 5, 14. So it is 4 here and 1 here. And 1 plus 8, 9. 9 plus 6, 15. You can also write like this, or you can also write like this. 15, 5, first number must be here and second number must be here. Don't write this number here and this number here. ones, tens. Ones place must be here and tens place must be here. Carried out. So 1 plus 5, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. And next, there is no carried out, leave it. 4 plus 3 is 7. 2 plus 2, 4. And 1 plus 1 is 2. So what is the answer? It is 22,78,546. So therefore, the total number of voters is 24,78,546. Okay. So these are the three questions I'll explain. Now, what you have to do is, what is the home assignment? What is the home assignment for today's class is? Home assignment. That means it's like a homework. Okay, so don't copy the questions. So the home assignment is frame out three new questions by changing the numbers. Changing the numbers in the previous questions. In the previous questions discussed. D-U-C-D-U-S-C-U-S-S-E-D. What do you mean by this? Don't write this and have a snap and don't send to me. It's not correct. So what I get is frame out three new questions. So what is the first question I explained? Just recall. I explained population. The number of males, I've given one number. And the number of females, I've given one number. Now what you have to do is this one. Change the numbers. Take your own numbers. Then do the question. Second question. Raju, account. So no sir, I hate Raju. I'll keep my name. Yes, you can keep your name. For example, my name Shyam. Shyam Prasad has some amount in SBI account and some amount in HDFC account. Total account you have to do. And third question, Kutbulapur constituency, number of voters. I've given one number. You don't copy the number, you change the number. Your wish, any wish. But better to take a bigger number. Don't take 3, 4. If you take 3, if it's very funny, don't take that. So here, now it's a logical thinking. All whenever you're doing the mathematics, don't restrict yourself to the particular question. You have to think in a such a way that it must be an innovative one and it must be related to this one. So these type of things are called as concept-oriented studies. So don't restrict yourself to the previous questions. I may give, just you copy the questions and write means you will write. It's not correct. Concept one. Now it's a time to change the framework. You have to think on and do your own questions. Okay. Hope you will do the things. And if you are unable to understand, don't worry. No need to be hurry and everything. You ask your elders. And it's very good wish that some of the parents are helping the students to do. It's very good. Keep it up. Respected parents, you keep it up that. You try to interact with the students. Mingle with them. You try to explain the concept. So, instead of wasting time with the other things, just you spend these 20 to 30 minutes with the students. So that they may be good, get good encouragement from your side. And they'll try to think in a new way. Okay. That's all for this session. In the next session, I'll explain the basics in subtraction. So once the subtraction is over, I'll go for a combination of addition and subtraction. Then multiplication, then division, then again combination. So total 8 classes in the 8 sessions, I'll explain this. Once we got a good idea about this one, then I'll go for your syllabus. Then the classes will be divided. Sir, I am reading 7th class. Why you are giving these questions? Don't say like that. It's a practice before entering into the subject. Okay. That's all for this session. Bye. We'll meet in the next session.